All right, welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you're new here, don't forget to like, subscribe, do all that good stuff, and let's get straight into today's video because the game has just updated. I was recording a video just before the update came out, and usually when we get these updates, we get a new character. So let's go ahead and go to the crew tab, and let's have a look at the new character that will be released in the next 2 days after the Monkey D. Dragon event. So we go to not owned, and let's see who the new character is. So the new character is Marco the Phoenix. Okay. So another Marco in the game. The old Marco is kind of really trash, so hopefully Marco gets a good character. Let's go see what his skills and abilities do. He's a strength character as well, so that's always good to know. The skill types rival. Okay. Interesting. So for the affinities, the first one, 25% attack, you'll need obviously Marco, you'll need Katakuri, and you'll need King and Rayleigh. That shouldn't be that bad. Katakuri, obviously a great character in the game. King is mid tier, Rayleigh, you can get him pretty early in the game. Next up we have is the HP, 25% HP. You obviously need Marco. Now this Zoro, most people probably won't have this Zoro because he's not a great character and you really shouldn't go for him, so maybe people won't have this one. Luffy Supernova, very free to play friendly, easy to get. Oh wow, Fruit Awakening. Oh wow, they're actually doing that to players. Wow, you have to have Luffy Nika form and Surgeon of Death Lore in order to get the 25% HP, in order to get the third affinity or link. Wow, they're actually doing that? That's crazy. That is... I don't agree with this. I mean, for the story, I understand, but wow, most people aren't going to have Nika Luffy form. So, if you want Marco at his full potential, you're going to need Nika Luffy form. Next up, we have Aziz Weapon, so then... Nirvana Wings, I think that's how you say it. Not sure. Then we have the Color Jade Rings, and... Oh, that's really good. It's just the Color Jades. It's not his own. Oh, wow, that's actually really good. That means his Jade and Necklace will be very easy to upgrade. Alright, let's have a look at his Fighting Spirit just before we get into the skills. Sky Hearts. This is a new Fighting Spirit. Special Fighting Spirit. It does not belong to the Four Spirits, okay? So Nika Luffy, he doesn't need to be one of the four. He can just be the last character. In all modes, increases 1% attack, gains 10 rage when he attacks. Okay. This would be interesting to see how high the attack scales and how high the rage scales. He could be hitting really hard, and he could gain a lot of rage when he attacks, so he could be getting his ult back. That's very interesting. And let's check out his passive. I'm not even going to bother trying to pronounce some of these things. His passive. Oh, I really like the way that they've done this. Where they've put the numbers. And they've actually stated what each individual thing does. Because going through all the characters' passives and abilities is so annoying to understand each line of text. And some of them don't even make any sense. Alright, so let's look at the passive. When Marco the Phoenix debuts, so when he's on your team, it increases his own attack by 20%, and he's permanently immune to all control effects. So just like Sir Crocodile, he's immune to all control effects. At the beginning of each turn, if the number of enemy skill type crew members is greater than or equal to 2, reduces the control rate and trigger probability of smoke skills of all enemy units by 25% for one turn. Okay, so this is a permanent effect, basically, because it's at the beginning of each turn. So, basically, permanently, you're reducing their control rate and trigger effects of their normal abilities by 25%. That's okay. It's not that broken or anything. It's okay. It's nice to have. Number 3, when attacking, permanently increases his trigger probability of small skills by 10% and rage growth rate by 20%. Which can be stacked. Okay, so every time he attacks, he gets 10% chance added onto his basic ability. And then he gets 20% rage growth rate. If there are skill type crew members on their enemy's field, their attack will be permanently increased by 3% each time they release an attack or deal damage, which can be stacked. What? If there are skill type crew members on the enemy's field, their attack will be permanent. This doesn't make any sense. Why would you be increasing their attack? I think it should be your attack. I think they've worded this wrong, and it should be your team's attack. For every time that the skill type crew members of the enemy team releases an attack. This doesn't make any sense. Alright, moving on, let's go to number four. When he is attacked, he has a 100% chance to reduce the damage suffered by this time by 20%, so 20% chance to reduce all attack. Then a 40% chance to reduce the damage suffered this time by 40%. I would assume that is the second attack. It's very weird how that they've worded this. Or 10% chance to reduce the damage suffered by this time by 90%. So I would assume the first attack that is on him, it gets reduced by 20% because he 100%, and then the second one he only has a 40% chance, and then the third attack he only has a 10% chance. Okay, interesting. If there are skill type crew members on the enemy's field, each time he is attacked, he will permanently increase his own lifesteal rate by 3%, can be stacked. Okay, that's all right. 3% every time. I mean, most teams only maximum run like three, maybe four skill types. Say three. Nami, Chopper. If you're running Law, that team runs three, and then Sir Crocodile if you're running in that team for some reason. Yeah, I think three's like the maximum you run. Maybe block rate team, you run three as well though. Yeah, I think three's the max that people run. So you're really only gonna get 9%. I mean, it can be stacked, I would say indefinitely. Okay, let's look at his basic ability. Michael the Phoenix deals 180% plus 20 points of damage to a line of enemy units. I really like that. And reduces the attacked target's damage reduction by 30%. That's really good. Really good. That first line, very good. When releasing a small skill, so this skill, he has a 70% chance to add a layer of blue flame shield to himself. Blue flame shield increases attack, crit rate, and damage bonus by 15%, so it can be attacked. That's really good. So every time he's using this attack, he has a 70% chance to gain those bonuses. Number three, when he releases a small skill, so this again, it would trigger whatever that means. Haki deals 120% attack points of damage to the enemy skill type crew members, and there is a 40% chance to dispel all buffs of the crew members who attacked. That's really good. Debuffing. This is a really hard counter to Hiyori. This right here is a really hard counter to Hiyori, because she grants so many buffs and she's a skill type character. This is a huge. Does this go off? There is a 40% chance. Okay, so it's not that great. 40% chance. Okay. When he releases a small skill, again, this, I don't know why they keep saying that. It's just this skill. If the number of enemy skill type crew members is greater than or equal to 2, his small skill damage will be increased by 50%. So his basic ability, this skill right here, will just be dealing an extra 50% damage. Okay, interesting. Now this will normally go off every time, unless you're playing against a strength team, then yeah, strength team will completely. I mean, he could be used in a strength team, maybe. Not sure, we'll have to see. Let's have a look at his ultimate ability. Micah the Phoenix deals 400% plus 25 points of damage to a single unit. The enemy's back row. Okay, not that great. Unless it one-shots. Trigger burning to death when he releases ultimate skill. There's an 80% chance to deal true damage of 200% attack. His attack and crit damage increase by 20%. Okay. So maybe it is a natural one-shot then. So you have an 80% chance to one-shot, I would assume. Okay, so this can be really good. There's a 100% chance, so... Okay, there's a 100% chance to deal additional damage of 160 to the enemy skill type. Wow, that's really good. So he just counters skill type crew members. Wow, he literally just counters skill type crew members. That's all he's designed for. I don't know if I really like that design of a character. The attack target's block rate and crit rate decreased by 20%, while damage suffered increased by 20%. Okay. Applies a debuff. Block rate 20%, that's not that much. That won't really affect block rate team too much. When he releases ultimate skill, if the number of any skill type members is greater than or equal to 2, his ultimate skill damage will be increased by 50%. Okay, so his ultimate will basically one-shot someone. His ultimate will just basically one-shot someone. Okay, so that's his kit right there. Let's just check. Does he have the same thing? Does more damage to enemies, damage increase? Yep. Doesn't have anything like the Nifigo Luffy. Okay, so that's basically Marco the Phoenix right there. He basically just counters skill type crews. Although the maximum that you really run on a team is 2 to 3. I'm not sure how I like this design of a character, just completely countering one type of crew. Let me know in the comment section down below what you guys think of the character. Do you think he's broken? Do you think he's not that great? What teams do you think he'll be good for? Yeah, just put all your thoughts on the new Marco the Phoenix. Now you can read this if you want. I'll just leave this here for a little bit. I'll just pause if you want to read this. And yeah. He will be coming in 2 days. As soon as this event leaves, he'll be coming. So, 1 day? Actually, he might be coming tomorrow. Is he coming tomorrow? Yeah, he actually is coming tomorrow, I think. Yeah, I think he's coming tomorrow. Alright, so if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, subscribe, do all that good stuff, and I'll see you guys in the next video.